everyone, welcome back to Clarinet with Tony. Today we are going to be talking about the A flat major scale. Okay, so let's get right into it. So A flat is basically you start on, let's go to the low G we talked about last episode. So thumb, 1, 2, 3 on the left hand, on the right hand, 1, 2, 3. So thumb, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And I call this number four here. So I go by 4, 5, 6, 7 on the for these pinky keys, and the first one closest to your finger or pinky finger is the A flat. So sounds like, so that's the first note, and the next note, B flat, C, D flat, or also known as C sharp, E flat, F, G, and then A flat. Okay, so one more time. A flat, B flat, C, D flat, E flat, F, G, A flat. Okay, so we have quite a few flats here in the scale. This is a good time to review some of the things that we talked about in the other episodes, where we were talking about lifting the clarinet for balance, and then when we lift the clarinet, we resist this action with our upper teeth and the bottom chin going like this, so that we don't swallow the clarinet, obviously. Like that. And then when we start to play, before we do that, we go, there's a rhythm, under current rhythm, we breathe in rhythm, so 1, 2, 3, and then we breathe in circular motion, we don't go, so there should be no kind of tense pause, basically, so 1, 2, 3, so we breathe one beat before the beat we come in. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. And then when we're playing, while we're doing the push up thing, we want to keep the fingers right above the tone holes. Even when we lift, we don't want to lift this way, or we don't want to lift this way or diagonally, always kind of more or less above the tone holes, because we want to keep it simple. We want to do either up or down. Okay, so when we go up, we don't want to get lost, right? We want to be tethered so that we come back, right? I always make the analogy to my students about, you know, imagine being an astronaut working on the, you know, like fixing something on the in exterior of the International Space Center or something, and then of course you want to be tethered, right? If you that gets disconnected, there's a big chance that, or there's a chance that you might not come back. So it's kind of a dark analogy, but anyway, so when we come back, we want to be coming back to the right place. We don't want to come back, you know, in the wrong places. Actually, in order to be able to come back in the right position, I'm trying to keep the spacing of my fingers the same. It's kind of like, you know, how string players, they have very specific finger spacing or fingerings for different notes, or finger position, hand positions, right? It's kind of the same thing.
Thank you.
tonguing, we want to have enough air going through, and you can think of it as not tonguing so much on the reed, because of course we're tonguing on the reed, but what that can create is that we often, students, they attack the reed first and then they blow, you get this kind of very percussive and strong attack. So we want to get smooth and non-abrasive tonguing as possible. And of course, different musical situations call for different styles of tonguing, but I think that's a good goal to have when you're practicing, trying to have as sneaky of disruption in the sound as possible. Yeah, okay? And at this point, if you are having trouble with tonguing, one way that could be good for you to improve your tonguing is tongue multiple times on the same note when you're playing the scale. Number of tonguing I do on each note by half. Try to keep that same nice long legato sound. Okay? I hope that was helpful. I'll see you guys on the next.